Hello everyone, and welcome back once again to the Vanishing of Ethan Carter. Last time we saw Dad, Ethan's dad, slowing down his mother. And Ethan escaped through a watered-down corridor to the outside. So now we're going to be exploring the outside ourselves. It looks like we ended up on the dam. Let's check out that building over there. See what's inside. Hello. There you are. Oh shit. That's Ethan's father's corpse. Probably Travis. Father was inside. He smashed the door with the axe, yelling, "Here's Travis!" Probably. Okay, here's the axe. Ah, shit. Poor guy. Looks like it's gonna be a while before we figure out what happened to him. Oh shit. Bloody scissors. And a lift. Crap. Looks like we know what Travis used to kill his father, the bastard. Okay. Time to get those scissors. If I'm not mistaken, we're looking this way, I think. Somewhere around here, or... perhaps if I follow the cables? Let's see. Cables go over here. Should be around here somewhere, I think. Wait, there's a path. There we go. Fucking hell, man. Yep. Here's Travis, that motherfucker. Where's the last one? There any more? Is that it?
Where is my mother? Why are you standing in the sleeper's way?
She had an accident. Travis, put down the axe.
Poor guy. He didn't want to kill his children, so he chose to kill himself instead. Little did he know that it wouldn't solve anything. Well, the sound of that engine gets on my nerves. There we go. Of course, red valve handle. Don't forget your roots. Resident Evil all the way. Finally. There we go. We can get out. Solving what happened to Ethan's father, we're going to be ending this video for now. Join me next time as we figure out what happened to Travis and how he ended up in the train tracks. Till then, thank you for watching once again, and I'll see you next time in The Vanishing of Ethan Carter. Take care.